we saw Sonya Deville and Mandy Sachs appear on Raw with Paige. And on SmackDown, we saw Ruby Riott, Sarah Logan. I was almost called her by her indie name. But Sarah Logan and Liv Morgan.
Mm-hmm.
Five NXT ladies all making their come up. Two almost identical groups. You've got a ring veteran who is kind of an anti-diva with a gothish look. You've got an extremely attractive blonde, and you have a hard-hitting, vicious brunette. It's literally the exact same thing on both shows, and they both did the exact same thing. Just beat the shit out of every diva that was on the, or I'm sorry, every woman that was on the show.
Grady. poor Becky. Like, they were beating the shit out of it. I was like, stop.
Becky's gonna cry.
Oh, I love Becky. Yeah, it was crazy. It was exciting. I don't know what this could mean. I mean, they're calling up, that's a lot of women to call up. Five women already called up and Paige is back. That's six women.
I'm a little confused as to what's happening. So, like, when after Paige made her return with the girls on Raw, I was kind of thinking about it. I'm like, all right, so the moment was cool. Glad to have her back. This stable could be dope. But what are they planning on doing with her? Because we've got Asuka.
Mm-hmm.
And Asuka's being built up as this unstoppable monster. So you kind of know it's only a matter of time before Asuka gets the women's championship.
Yeah.
Is Asuka going to get the women's championship and then Paige is Paige being built up so she can be the one to take Asuka out? Is Paige being built up so she can get the women's championship and then Asuka can beat her for it? But at the same time, you can't, like, if Asuka just, cuz Asuka's already been made to look dominant, more dominant than anyone.
Yeah.
They do need it, like, somebody new or at least somebody who's been away for a while to get rebuilt up so somebody can take her out. And if they have the numbers on her, she might not lose anything from, you know, losing the streak to her.
I could see her losing the streak to Paige.
But it was all just very confusing to me. And then SmackDown happens. And when I heard about it, because I heard about it before I saw it, for some reason, like, I had just heard that these girls had come up, and I was assuming that Paige was with them, too.
Yeah.
And I'm like, oh, my God, this is amazing. Paige is on both shows, and she just keeps bringing NXT talent to just assault people. This is genius. But then I find out that Paige is not a part of it on SmackDown. So I'm glad right now they're in a happy space, because we don't know anything yet. We have no information. We don't know how long that's going to last. Maybe Paige starts talking again on Monday and explains herself. But for now, we don't know what's going on. I'd like to see these two events connected.
Yeah, it would make sense for them to connect.
Somehow. Because, like I said, it's two groups that are exactly the same, doing the exact same thing, literally one night after the other.
Yeah. So I don't... I mean, maybe they'll switch. Maybe it's not just them going to Raw, them going to SmackDown. Maybe they'll switch and then have some of them go... Like, they'll be cross. Like, cross-brand? Is that what it's called? I don't know what it's called. Like, they do both, like John Cena.
Right.
That'd be interesting.
Zeno in the live chat is new to this page, just liked it, and he's just joining the live chat for the first time. Welcome, Zeno. Feel free to share your thoughts just like everybody else is. A lot of people are saying these pairings are random. I like it. The Raw pairing doesn't seem random to me at all, because Mandy Sachs and Sonya Deville have kind of been together for a while, ever since they did Tough Enough together, and Paige was a judge on that season of Tough Enough.
Mm-hmm.
So they do have that connection. In terms of Ruby Riott, Sarah Logan, and Liv Morgan, those three girls couldn't be any more different from each other.
Yeah,
that's kind of a random pairing, and because it's happening the same, like I said, literally the day after that, I wonder if maybe there's, like, a mastermind behind it all. Like, maybe not even Paige. Like, maybe somebody else is controlling this. Like, I don't know who. maybe we see William Regal show up on Raw or SmackDown and like and kind of start taunting both Daniel Bryan and Kurt Angle, and maybe he's behind these NXT women taking them out. I'm just throwing out stuff, but I'm they had me curious.
And a lot of curiosity came from this. A lot of curiosity came, is this leading up to a future women's Royal Rumble? Because so many women just got called up. And now there's a lot of talks of it that people are like, well, maybe this is it. They're finally building more women so they can have a female Royal Rumble.